So thanks, Asha. Thanks for inviting me. And very briefly about the background. So I did my BTech from ISM IIT Dhanbad in 2000. Then Diamond Joka in 30th batch along with Asu and Manu. And post that, spent first 6-7 years of 5 to 6 years of career across various consulting companies, PwC and NTT Docomo in India and in US. Then joined 197 after some moving around into way back in 2007, parent of Paytm. Hardly anybody knew at that time. Startups were not trendy as they are today. So a lot of people told me that pata nahi kya kar raha hai career ke saath. So going downhill kind of a thing. But in hindsight, obviously, it has been great. So 2007 to 2010 is when I spent the first 3 years at 197. Okay. And the company grew very fast even at that point of time. So last job was right now, since IPO is in fashion. In fact, this is the second time that 197 Paytm is planning to do an IPO. First one was in way back in 2002. That was in fact one of my last projects at Paytm 197 at that point of time. 2010 is when I left to start my own company called Akshmala, which was into agri-tech way back in 2010. So you can understand, way ahead of its time. And we bootstrapped it to $1 million kind of a run rate at that time, annual revenues, not run rate, also like hardcore revenues of $1 million. Ran out of my money. So in between, Vijay wanted me to be back at Paytm. Paytm had started growing now, like though it had been created before I left in 2010. By 2014, when I started sort of trying to find out how to make my ends meet, Vijay made me an offer to come part-time to them. So I spent almost a year part-time as the HR head and one of the business heads of Paytm while running my own startup. Okay, very, very different and unique kind of an arrangement, but worked well both for me and Vijay. So I spent some time there. Then Alibaba round happened. I was significantly involved in it. So once that round happened, I joined formally Paytm full time. And meanwhile, Ashok had continued with Akshmala in a parallel world. I was involved as an advisor, not operationally, after 2015. That is when I started working full time with Paytm. Paytm, I spent 2014 to 2019. Having various roles, CFO, CHRO first for Paytm, and also a business lead. Then forked out Mall as an independent business, started heading it, was on its board. Then in between, incubated the bank, incubated the gaming business, was involved in quite a few other setups and all that. There was never a dull moment. Then 2019 is when I came back to Paytm from Mall, 2018. Then joined, started off on the insurance business to build it up. That is when I decided. Meanwhile, Ashok, my partner, was pivoted Akshmala into Unnati 1.2, I would say, first stuff. So some bit of, I would say, direct to farmer kind of a engagement model on agri inputs is what we started off with. 2019 September is when I came back to Paytm, to Unnati, and we rebuilt the whole thing in a different format now. And obviously, after the moment I came back, 6 mahine ke andar, it was COVID scenario, so things changed a lot on ground also for us. But luckily, the good part was that we got a lot of time to build up a product without too much of a revenue pressure, because we knew that we can't go out to the field with the whole thing. So 2019 onwards, Ashok and I started building this Unnati in the current form. Okay. Idea is very simple, that we go ahead and create and all of you who have sort of seen the agriculture ecosystem would have seen that there's a significant lack of digitization around the farmer sort of ecosystem. So companies are digitized and all, but small farmers and all still are quite a distance away from availing of digital services or using digital methods to do things. So that is where Unnati is trying to come in, to sort of build a build a digital platform on which we can get the farmer, so I would say the farmer solutions to be built and delivered. So till now, so one of the theses going back to what we are trying to do at Unnati is that, you know, farming is divided into multiple industries. Like farming in itself is a large one. There is a whole agri input side. There is a whole equipment side of the story. There is financial services, the whole agri lending and banking space. And then there is the food processing output side of the story, which is again divided into multiple layers. Now, all of these work independently in silos. A farmer is at the center of it, but he doesn't get a, most of the companies actually end up trying to create services into individual segments of it. Whereas, you know, input, what input a farmer is using is very much going to impact what output is going to get. So, you know, with Unnati, what we are trying to do is get everybody onto the platform as a large scale ecosystem, digital ecosystem, so that we can create the right solution for the farmers and deliver as a solution. So it's a classic difference between individual line items of a service versus giving farmers a solution onto the whole thing. So our buildup is towards this. So logically, what we have done is we have divided our sort of plans into three parts. First phase, what we are doing is building the rails, okay, is as we call, to reach out to the farmers digitally. Okay, while I agree that there is a lot of usage of Facebook and all, but the actual usage of the services and stuff at the farmer level is still sort of significantly pending. So that is where what we are doing is we are digitizing the small stores who are selling inputs, who are selling, let's say, small equipments. And that's why I would definitely be very happy to engage back and bring those small equipments to the farmer, because that is a very clear stated agenda for us. So what we are doing is we have an app called UStore, which we give to all these small input retail stores, small equipment stores, the non-tractor ones typically, to the warehouses. So it has different elements, to the small traders who are purchasing from the farmer directly, okay, to manage their own business so that they have an interest in using the platform itself. And we have a platform as an open platform rather than us trying to do everything on the platform. And then we make our revenue model on the products that we sell to the intermediary use stores, who actually then go ahead and work with the farmers and digitize that relationship via our platform. Okay, so that's the approach that we have taken. That we first, in the first 1.5 years, we are digitizing these stores, creating that digital network of stores. We already at around 15,000 plus of such stores. And then we go ahead and sort of digitize the relationship between the farmer. So the approach is to engage with the farmer directly using an app. We also have a farmer app, which we are running in beta right now, which has a voice interaction and all involved there. I'll come to that in a while. While we keep transacting via these small partners who are there on the ground delivering our services. So that's the overall approach at Unnati, that we work with small stores, small traders to go ahead and digitize them, help them expand their business and digitize the relationship between the farmer and the retailer. Okay. So this gives us a hook and a trusted hook, so to say, in every community that exists in the rural segment to go ahead and engage with the farmers and bring the farmers on board. Okay. So that service becomes relevant for them. So this is what we are doing at Unnati. Phase one is building the rails. Phase two is when we are launching our financial services. So one product we piloted out where we did a credit line product for our UStore partners. As we build the data, we will extend it to the farmers. We are starting with the intermediary partners who are there, the traders and the stores. In phase three, which is where the real sort of impact of technology will be seen, okay, is where all of these transactions, the data for the transactions plus data from, say, the satellite integrations that we are doing on our app, the soil data and all, will then create the recommendation engine and platform for delivering the right recommendation, individualized recommendation to the farmer based on his farm, his crop, data, his crop history, what products he has been using and all. Okay, and that will be delivered in the context of the transaction that he is doing. So for example, we are looking at scenarios where, let's say, he is buying a product which leaves a pesticide residue in the crop. Now that will impact his ability to export it, because it will not be sold in the export for the export market. So that input we can give not later, but right at that time when he is purchasing that input, that hey, if you are putting this particular product, then you might have a challenge of accessing the export market. Either don't do it, and this will make your earnings go from, let's say, X to a delta X or like minus delta X kind of thing. So those kind of scenarios is what our predictive model is working on to go ahead and deliver that thing. Obviously, there is a lot of data and training that are required for the model since early days there. We do expect another 2.5 years before we are able to deliver those kind of recommendations to the farm. Okay, so this is in a brief what we are trying to do at Unnati: create a digital distribution and aggregation model. Even today, what we do is, because we know what variety of seeds a farmer has sown, how much acreage he has sown, we know what is the kind of a output can be expected there. So at the time of harvest, we reach out to them, tell them that, oh, this is the price that is the prevailing in the market at this point of time. Do you want to sell it at this point of time or store it? Okay, if you want to store it, then it goes into one of the maybe the partnered warehouses, which again are running our software. So the idea is that we, being the tech players, go ahead and extend the technology backbone to all the on-ground partners, get them to work with us on it, and then offer the solution to the farmers via these intermediary partners. Okay. So today, as I said, we already have crossed around. So in March, we did around 20 CR worth of GMV, so to say, on our platform. So good demand, very good traction. This was almost 9-10x of what we did in October. So in fact, we got funded in October from NABARD. And contrary to a lot of the VC funded models, we are very much contribution margin positive. So very little burned that way. Okay. So, but we raised our first round from NABARD, NAB Ventures, which was a strategic choice for us because of obviously that NABARD has a big name in the Indian agriculture segment. It gives us a lot of sort of, I would say, quasi-government kind of a thing on top of a sheen of quasi-government player there on the front. Plus, they are helping us a lot in terms of the on-ground deployment, like with FPOs and all. Next week, there's a version of U-Store called Digital FPO, which we are launching in Bihar. So our operations right now are in around 45 districts across Maharashtra, UP, and Bihar. And a few districts in Haryana, Rajasthan, Punjab, and we should be expanding into AP and Telangana in the next 1 month or so. So till now, 2.75 lakh farmers have transacted to the platform. And out of maybe a total reach of around 6 to 7 lakh farmers that would be existing via our fulfillment partners on the platform. And yeah, that's it pretty much in terms of the traction and what we are seeing. Definitely hoping to make a unicorn out of it, at least. and you know, it's a very interesting time for us to be in agriculture, because very rightly said, like last 1-1.5 years, there has been a lot of focus on agri tech per se. And I think there's a whole lot of both demand and supply side, plus regulatory challenges that have been or are being solved at a very aggressive pace. So for example, till last year, it was only in Bihar that we could have purchased material legally instead of trying to do some sort of hanky-panky. But this year, because of the regulatory changes, places in UP, Bihar and all have also sort of, Maharashtra and UP also have started working very well in terms of the sourcing of farm produce and all. So there are regulatory challenges which are getting solved. There's a lot of adoption of digital any which way. So for example, this second wave of COVID, we launched a feature where we are saying that to the retailers that take your store to the farmer's shop. So it's a farmer's doorstep. So essentially, the thought is that you can actually send the your store's whatever material is available and all to the farmer as a card, okay, or as a catalog listing via WhatsApp, which then the farmers can place an order from there. So they don't have to go to the shops, because shops are open only for 2 hours. So no need to crowd there or do anything, but do everything remotely. And make the payment via UPI, and then you are sort of, you just have to either go and pick, or the retail partner can go ahead and get it delivered. Okay. So that is what we are doing. We are trying to get the connection through a single hop to the farmer, both for the input brands, the large input brands, the smaller ones. And on the reverse side, also help the like the food processing partners, like let's say the ITCs, Britannias of the world, Godrejas of the world, to source as much as possible directly from the farmer. With or definitely there will be, you know, it will never be a scenario where we'll have zero, you know, zero intermediary involvement, because there is a lot of on-ground support that is required in terms of grading, doing the aggregation, doing the first level of quality check and stuff before it gets sold to the food processors. So, but yeah, but what we are seeing is that with this model, one, we are not breaking the sort of distribution and aggregation chains, both on the input and output side. At the last mile, what we are doing is breaking it at the larger distributor level and all. But at the last mile, they, we are partnering with a lot of these smaller retailers. So the first level trust that needs to be built with the farmer gets built up very fast, because we have a on-ground partner who is sort of branded and partnering with us to convert him into a digital store. On one side, the farmers become find a good sort of a digital method to do, and on the other hand, the store partners get an opportunity to expand their business, because till now they were only able to be limited in their small geography area, whereas they would have been expanding on this. So, I think that's like, I can keep on going on and on, actually, it's my baby, but I would take a pause here and would be happy to answer questions about this or the past Paytm life or whichever way it works, because obviously, like, this is one dream which I've been holding on since 2010, and this is a second stab. So, in one very early days philosophy, after doing a lot of foolish things when we used to do initial phases of our agri sort of, because as you can understand, as a mining engineer, I am kal maybe aisa kuch agri se related kiya nahi jindagi mein. My dad was not a farmer, so I had to learn it the hard way by going out to the field. And but then it is a very interesting problem to be solved. You know, if it is solved at scale, and it has to be an India model. You know, India is very different as far as the agri landscape goes from, as compared to any other country, apart from a few Southeast Asian countries. We are very different. So whatever solution we build will definitely make a huge, huge impact on the economy, on the people whom it is sort of leading to. And I think if we are able to build a commercially viable setup on that, we would be creating something for posterity, a really long haul stuff on that. So would be happy to answer questions also and not bored with my monologue on this.
Thanks, Amit. I also got to know a lot of things for the first time. Before we go into the question part also, just wanted to let you know that one comment here is also just to let your, you know, tell about your ask, how the larger IMC community can help. And we'll let that message go out also. And whichever people who are there, if there's something specific that we can do also, we can, we'd like to contribute, and we'll offer that also.
So we'd be very happy actually to partner with all the product and services folks who want to reach out to the farmers via a digitally enabled network of stores. Okay. And then, and that extends. So for example, like on the NBA, on the credit services side, we are partnering with multiple people to create products which can be co-created and delivered to the farmers via the tech platform. Similarly, on a lot of these products, which is especially now that in the last 1 year we have a significant network created, the focus next is to get more sort of nuanced and good quality products that we can take it to the farmers. And so that's why this is the perfect ideal time for us. Over the next 6 to 9 months, we are looking to build up a good volume of products which can be sort of launched on the platform itself. Okay, so that is something that definitely we are looking forward to. Third, obviously, see, at the end of the day, our strength is in the reach that we are building, okay, both on the input and the output side. The more we collaborate with various people to take these services and keep building on that, the better our farmers can get the services and also do more and more things on the platform, so that we have data enough, information enough that we can create those protocols for the farming in future. Okay, so would be happy to partner on all kinds of things. Very open thought process as a platform. Both me and Ashok are very clear that the challenges are too many to be solved vertically by us as a single player. We can never do that. I'll be very honest. I don't think it is solvable also if I try to do everything on my own. That's why the focus is on getting the best of the breed. Like recently we tied up with Satyuk, which is a satellite data company, to take their solutions to the farmers in terms of moisture variation across the field. And then if we can recommend the right amount of irrigation that can be varied. And so we are doing pilots on that, but the idea is that we get such more and more such partners to come along with us to the farmer and work out a commercial model between us. So I think all sorts of partnerships from that front would be really happy. In terms of funding is always welcome from anybody that comes, but we are close to our Series A closure right now. In fact, that is one of the things that is really keeping me busy, and hopefully we will have, not a PA, but we'll have more people in the team so that we can respond to a lot of these things, like the whole NSDC thing. While I'm broadly aware of the benefits and all, have never picked up, mainly because we need somebody to drive it as a dedicated activity from our side also. So now we are building up those teams and stuff, so would be happy to do that. Also happy to have a lot of references for team members and all, whom we can potentially get on board with us. Okay, and now that we have some funding coming, so we can hope to have a sort of a market competitive salary and stuff package for whoever is joining. But so these are pretty much, I think, on the team side. If people want to come over and join and sort of have a good ride along with us, and second, on the partnerships front, would be happy to pick up all the possible partnerships and do this thing, especially on the small equipment, on the input product side. There are quite a few. In fact, there was one senior of ours who was in Maharashtra who is working on a few bio products and all, with whom we were trying to collaborate. So before COVID, during the COVID time, it got a bit delayed. So, but then definitely would be happy. The current focus for us is credit partnerships and distribution partnerships for agri inputs and the small agri equipment segments. And then output will come after that. This is how we are looking at it. And rest will keep on exploring tie-ups. Like our network of farmers is available for people who really want to build some tech product, okay? And they want, like for Satyuk, we are bringing in a bunch of thousands of farmers to them, okay? So that we can fine tune the protocol across multiple crops, multiple geographies, okay? So similarly, would be happy to open our network to bring in other relevant such products, which require a lot of data and interactions and on-ground execution to be done on our platform.
Yeah. So yeah, thank you so much. Yeah. I give you the time now for the last comments and then we can close. Yeah. Amit.
So really great. So as an overall initiative, I know I've been very patchy in responding to a lot of the stuff, but I think it's a great stuff that you're doing, because I keep looking at the messages and the stuff, and then really many times I've been putting off, mainly because of the time constraint and stuff at my end, but would be happy to sort of collaborate with everybody and with you also in terms of extending more and more into it. It's also a form of giving back to the community and not only a commercial interest that way. So would be happy to engage and do more stuff, and with you, with the platform, otherwise with everybody else also on the IMC community.
Thank you so much. Yeah.
Thanks.
Bye, everyone. Yeah.
Thank you.